Live Alive was the directorial debut of Takashi Tokita, who set out to make a game telling multiple stories, all in one narrative. The anthology format and storytelling has never had too much commercial success, despite being a favorite mechanism for auteurs like Quentin Tarantino. Takita going against the grain, combined with the game never leaving Japan, may have been the main contributor to its poor sales. After release, only 270,000 units were sold, which is considered a pretty big flop. Still, its impact was pretty tremendous, considering it helped lay the foundation for the 1995 commercial hit Chrono Trigger, a game that also placed heavy importance on time travel, real-time strategy combat, and multiple endings. Because the original Famicom game never had an international release, most of the world had never even heard of Live Alive before the announcement for the remake on the Nintendo Switch. I know I had it, and I love classic Square RPGs. Fortunately, the team at Aeon Genesis created a pretty good English translation patch of the original game, and they even went as far as to add different fonts for each era, a small but nice improvement on the original material. Breaking from the standard formula, where each level gets progressively more difficult, Live Alive's chapters are all relatively the same difficulty. That way you could play them in any order. Another unusual choice, but one that Tokita felt would give the players more say in how the story unfolded. Seven famous manga artists were brought in to design the seven eras. This was a creative way to ensure that each section of the game didn't just feel like a different time period, but a different genre altogether. Notable artists include Gosho Aoma, creator of Detective Conan, and Yumi Tamura, creator of Basara. The distant future is inspired by 2001 A Space Odyssey. The Wild West's protagonist is designed after Clint Eastwood, and the present-day narrative drew inspiration from contemporary Japanese wrestlers. Takita really was aiming for something ambitious, and it's amazing that he and his team were able to put together something cohesive from such weird and different ideas. Yoko Shimomura was the sole composer in Live Alive, and it was her very first job after joining Square. She would go on to make some of the best video game soundtracks of all time, notably Secret of Mana, Super Mario RPG, and of course, Kingdom Hearts. It's no surprise that the remake resembles Octopath Traveler so much. Takashi Tokita joined the team responsible for Traveler, and after seeing its success, he was convinced the market was finally ready for Live Alive again. If you like this video, please subscribe to Wes Is Doing Things. I'm just getting started out on YouTube, and all your likes and subscribes and all that are really appreciated. Thanks for watching, I'll see you next time. Oh.